All right. Hello, and welcome to this week's session of the Virtual Job Seekers Network. My name is Greg Cooper. I'm the Manager of Employment Connections here at the college. And this week, we have the pleasure of speaking with Tanya Persecki from Fastenal. Before we allow her the time to introduce herself and her wonderful organization, we'll take some time for some general housekeeping tips. For the people live in attendance, you are able to ask questions throughout the interview. We only ask if you want to ask a question that you use the raise hand feature on the bottom of your Microsoft Teams meeting. And once you raise your hand at a strategic break, I'll try to take the time to call on the person, and you can turn on your mic, turn on your camera, and then ask your question. There will also be time for questions at the end of the interview, and where you can ask, you know, either questions to me or Tanya about, you know, her particular position, general job search tips, or maybe, you know, what type of positions that she sees coming up in, you know, in the near future. And if you're watching the recording, please feel free to email your questions to employmentconnections@fetc.edu. Once we receive those questions, we'll do our best to either connect with Tanya if it's a question that's specific for her, or we'll try to take the time to answer your questions and help you out with your job search. So, without further ado, Tanya, can you please introduce yourself, your current role, your background, education, maybe previous roles?
Sure. Thank you. I appreciate the time today. My name is Tanya Parsetsky. I work for Fastenal, Fastenal in Oshkosh. I have a bachelor's degree from University of Wisconsin-Stevens Point. Quite a long time ago, but I do have it, and I specialize in human resources. My role at Fastenal really kind of wears a lot of hats, but my primary focus is recruiting. I recruit for our facility in Oshkosh, and we have about over 60 employees, entry-level employees, also picking, packing, warehouse. We have a quality department, purchasing and sales, global sales, that kind of thing. So quite a big division here. We are specifically helping Oshkosh Defense. This is only dedicated to Oshkosh Defense and their building of the trucks. So you can see the truck print behind me. So this location that I work out of is just supporting that situation. But we do have many other locations. In fact, we have 12 other locations throughout the valley.
One second, Tanya, just before you talk about the different locations, your camera is sideways. Is there a way that you can switch it to
that way?
Yep, that way. That's that perfect.
Yep, sorry.
That's perfect. No problem.
Okay, there we go. Yeah, so we have 13 different locations from Fond du Lac all the way to Sturgeon Bay. So I do recruiting for that as well and help out in that manner. Prior roles have really ranged from working in human resources, more in the field of staffing, that kind of thing, to I was a real estate agent for 12 years as well as that. So kind of a diverse background as far as what I want to do, a lot of sales. In fact, my complete title is sales support, recruiting HR support. So at Fastenal, that's really where I wear all the hats because I can do a lot of different things with that title. So kind of a, you know, long background of work. I've been with Fastenal for 5 years. So this is going on my 6th year with them. For those of you who don't know what Fastenal is, we are an industrial supply and distribution company. So it's a lot. But what that means is we supply companies with needs that they need industrial. So for instance, Oshkosh Defense, like we mentioned, anything it is to build their trucks on the inside of their trucks or even on the outside, the maintenance required things, the safety, you know, this time period we're in right now, we've been able to supply them with masks and hand sanitizers and things we can get our hands on and do that quite easily. On the other side of that that branch or those locations that you may be a little bit more familiar with throughout the area, those are going to have many different people they sell to. So for instance, they sell to schools and hospitals and industries, manufacturing environments. Many people equate Fastenal to having this, I'm trying to find a good picture for you, having a, I'm being familiar with what's called a vending machine. And these vending machines are actually like a vending machine, like you would find in a typical candy, that kind of thing, but they're actually tools. And many people who I meet with and network with can kind of put a face to that. So they may have worked at Bemis for a time or Amcor for a time frame in their background, or have been in some other facility and actually remember those Fastenals. And they're blue. And I don't have one to show you right now, but they're blue and they look like a vending machine, and they really are set up so people, it kind of cuts down usage. It's a great tool for companies to use to make sure that they're keeping track of inventory. So a real specialized kind of unique scenario when it comes to Fastenal. So and those branches can sell anything from A to Z. So you name it, the salespeople can find it for them. Do you mind if I just keep going? Because I can. Okay. I didn't know if you had any other questions, but that's really the background of what we do. That's kind of where I sit. I work a lot with Fox Valley Tech, and I enjoy it. I enjoy doing these things. I think the more networking, the more people we can be in touch with, the better our odds are of finding good students, good people to work for us. So that's my primary goal. Our jobs can be entry level, all of them. We, like I mentioned, we have a picking and packaging facility here in Oshkosh. We also have one in Greenville, which is near the airport. And it's a smaller location than here, probably more like 25 employees. But the nice thing about that is we're able to hire students on a flexible schedule, working with your semesters. Had a number in the past, I bet you 3 to 4 years, we've probably had close to 20 students between the Oshkosh and the Greenville location. And it's some of them have stayed right on to further their career with us. So that's been a really good benefit. It kind of goes back to really what our culture is about and what as a team, the hiring managers and myself and the other people that work with recruiting, really our goal is to bring people in on a part-time basis when they're in school and train them and learn, have them learn what the culture is of Fastenal, kind of a date before Mary kind of thing, you know, get that insight into what they're like and what they like about Fastenal and vice versa, what the employer can learn about that student. And because we have that flexibility, for instance, in Greenville, you can work anywhere the hours between 7 and 3. In Oshkosh, it's a little bit bigger, so we have more of an opportunity. And that could be anywhere from between 7 and 10 at night. It just depends. And we have students that take advantage of that. They really, really want that ability to be flexible. So it's something that it draws students. The other draw is that we can employ them afterwards, because just in Fastenal itself, we have accounting, we have you know, human resources, we have engineering, we have quality control, sales, obviously marketing. In itself, the positions that are available throughout the world, really, because we're an international company as well, really kind of is endless. So get people in the door when they can work and learn about the company and then move them right on into a full-time role after graduation is really our primary goal.
Yeah, so, and I'll just chime in there. Mm-hmm. So I guess before we get too far into the story here, you talked about you said you have a bachelor's degree, correct?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So what was your bachelor's degree in, if you don't mind me asking?
Sure. It was a bachelor's in communications, bachelor's okay. Science communications. So in the days that I went to school, they didn't have an HR degree. So you had to emphasize. So it was an internal, communication with an emphasis in HR, I think is what it ended up being. So
And so I think that's interesting because you talk about, you know, your background being kind of a varied background in a lot of different areas, which is great for students to realize that just because they might have graduated or might be going to school for one thing, that doesn't mean that they are completely, you know, taken away from, you know, looking at other career opportunities, because there are a lot of transferable skills in a lot of your different programs that can transfer into a lot of jobs.
Certainly.
So one question for you is that you talk a little bit about the jobs that you hire for and the opportunity for people to move on and become full-time employees. What are some of those entry-level positions? What could a new candidate expect to be applying for or doing within those entry-level roles?
So in, let's just give Greenville, for instance. That facility is working with Pierce Manufacturing, building their trucks, similar to, like I said, I mentioned that this location that I'm at in Oshkosh. Those are positions that are working with in the warehouse, picking and packaging parts ready to take on site to Pierce, to the different locations. Basically, we're filling their bins, their lines to keep them building. And so there's a lot of different things that go into effect. We're going to have people who are with the customers, talking to them, finding out their needs. What are their sales? What do they need to buy from us? Their distribution needs. Or there's just the typical entry level picking and packaging, not going on site to the customer, staying inside in the warehouse and maybe learning some of the purchasing or the invoicing pieces of it. So those are some of the things that are learning through Fastenal, and what we really try to instill, maybe give a round picture, give everybody a chance to do that. You know, there's a job that might be a little bit more physical, for instance, going on site and really unloading those parts and pieces onto the locations. And that might not be fitting for someone. So they would rather stay at the warehouse and just do the typical picking and packaging. And vice versa, the same thing could happen in Oshkosh, but you have to hire for those roles and cross train and make sure everyone knows a little bit about it. Because, you know, like any position, you want to be able to grab out what you can. I just ran across a statistic that said that entry level and sales support roles, which is really what we hire for in sales support, over 95% that we have hired currently, general managers that are currently hired, were promoted from within. So that is a true culture. It is what we talk about. That's really what I discuss. You know, when you're talking 95% of the people who are actually purchasing or actually in the general manager role were promoted. That's not exterior hiring. That's keeping those people. I think the executive team, I think other than two on the executive team at corporate in Winona, Minnesota, they were part-time sales support staff. Before they, you know, and they may have been going to college, most likely they were at the same time, but that's really what we're trying to introduce and understand. And it's truly become part of the entire culture of Fastenal. One of the other things I was thinking about is, so that's just the scenario of more of the warehouse. Our roles in the branch locations, in the general locations, and where you're going to see the white trucks with the blue logo on the side, and they're going to be in your towns. Like I said, there's 13 between Fond du Lac and Sturgeon Bay. Those locations are hiring for sales support staff. So as well as when I'm recruiting for the warehouse positions, the more entry level, the sales support staff at the branch locations are just as recruited just as much by me, depending on their openings. And those are going to start really similar to what the warehouse positions are, but they're in a location and really dealing with several different hundreds of different customers and assisting that the sales associates or the outside sales reps in there, you know, what their needs are, where they're at. So there's just a lot of varying opportunities, if you will. I think they are endless. It really, typically we're looking for customer site warehouse, customer site packaging, or sales support. Is it going to be that? Those are the roles you'll see open.
All right. And so I guess just in light of what's going on now with the pandemic, can you talk to us about what your typical hiring process looks like for, you know, maybe a few different positions, And then, have any changes been made to this process due to the onset of the current pandemic?
Sure. We were essential employees, everyone with Fastenal. We had majority of people, I kept coming to work every day. And we didn't recruit actively during the first, like I would say, most of April and May. Yeah, I would say April and May almost entirely. We just didn't. We're on a hiring freeze, very similar to most companies right now. It is starting to open up a little bit. We've had interviews last week. We have interviews this week. So we do have openings. We are pursuing employees. You know, we've been able to hire people, which has been really great. When we weren't interviewing and we weren't really actively looking for those couple months, it was difficult. We lost some of our workforce just for one reason or another. So we're really trying to get back up to speed and where we need to be. And when we did that, you know, we weren't having any hands-on. We were just doing phone interviews and really not meeting people. And I will tell you, that's a difficult place to be. So I'm really glad to see that we can bring people in and that we're able to meet them face-to-face, because it's just phone interviews just, or even virtual interviews, just don't do it. There's just a lot of things you miss when you're doing that. And I appreciate that we're able to have that technology, but I really like to meet people face to face.
Yeah, really get a great sense of who people are and things. But unfortunately, again, you know, for most companies, that's just not, you know, the case, and they don't have the option of bringing people. So maybe this is a great segue into what are some of your tips that you could give to a student that might be interviewing for, you know, a company right now. You know, are there any best practices for maybe the phone interview and then also in person? What are you looking for out of a candidate?
Sure. I think, excuse me, best practices is really just being open and honest. I think what I have noticed out of the younger group of individuals is just really thinking about that resume and what that looks like. There's a number of ATS systems, applicant tracking systems, that will catch resumes that aren't, you know, you're not following the right guidelines. Maybe they have a picture on it, or I don't know, the wording, the font's huge or something like that, just to fill up a space. You know, just really consider that. Use you all, the career services people, to help with that, because I think that's so important for students to understand the ins and outs of what's, you know, particular, what should we concentrate on. And I definitely have seen, I think I've seen a change when, or I know when someone's had some help with, you know, when they're young and they're really looking for that chance. And I value that. I really do, because I think that means they've put a little bit of extra effort. And anytime you put a little extra effort in something small, like a resume, or even, you know, really paying attention during the interview or however that looks, it means that you're going to pay attention later and you're going to be a good, potentially a good employee. I definitely think that in right now in our hiring, everything's going to be different from this point on, whether it be, you know, more phone, you know, interactions or virtual interactions. We don't do really anything paper with, you know, so it's important to be schooled and to understand, you know, each company. You can only get on our website to, you know, to the career page to find our positions. I do post on Tech Connect, and we use that often. And I think that's the message to get out to employers, is there are options. There are, you know, really free options out there, and that you should take advantage of those things and put those jobs out there. So I hope that answers your question. I kind of went on a different tangent. But
I think you got a lot in there. I mean, you gave a lot of great tips, even hopping into the resume portion too of, you know, trying to, you know, I always like to call it as beating the applicant tracking system, so that, you know, your resume is one of those 25 resumes that are seen. So I've recruited in the past as well, and I understand a lot of people, you know, the systems catch things like, you know, if you don't use the right keywords, if it can't read the font, or if it can't read, you know, that resume may never get seen. So those are some of the things that we try to help our students that come in. We try to help them with, you know, things that will help their resumes get through those systems. So I guess just in closing here, what would you say would make a candidate successful? What have you seen has been some of those character traits or some of the things that you know, when a person walks in or starts their first day on the job, makes them successful?
I think first and foremost, you know, appearance, looking your best, really, you know, you don't need the shirt and tie when you're going for a warehouse position. I get that, but really just arriving early, if not back, you know, make sure you're not late because all of those things have happened. You know, arriving early, being prepared for the interview, understanding probably the biggest thing that I would tell any applicant is understand the role that you're applying for, and not just the role, but the actual company. Do some research. We have incredible videos online of what Fastenal is. Their YouTube videos, they tell you everything, because I can't tell you how many times you're going to walk into an interview and the first question is what do you know about Fastenal, or what do you know about whatever position? You know, it's pretty important. And I have had time and time again that people will say, oh, you sell nuts and bolts. And I'm like, well, there's yes, but there's a lot more to it. And I think being prepared is half of it. You know, knowing your audience is the second part of that. You know, you don't need to know me personally, but if you know my company, you're going to get one step up. It's just going to be on there. It's going to be in every, any interview you do. So
that's great advice. And I mean, I think often that's overlooked is that, you know, that people aren't doing their research on the companies they're applying for. So, thank you for all of the great information. I mean, I've learned a lot too about Fastenal, and I didn't know kind of the complexity of what actually goes on and kind of the different levels of your organization. So I would like to take this last 8 minutes or so and open it up. So if there's anyone who is in the chat right now or in the meeting, if you would like to ask any questions, now is the time to do so. You can raise your hand. You can turn your camera on and ask a question. The question can be directed towards me, towards Tanya, and we will do our best to give you an answer. I'll just give it a little time in case people are typing.
You know, one thing I didn't speak about was the internships. I think we talked about that in that program, working with the marketing department. And that's the only department we've worked with for this at Fox Valley Tech. But really just understanding that program's out there and, you know, and offer it to your students. And when I come to the job fairs and the career fairs, we really talk about that and the opportunities, especially if I come across a business student and discuss that in general. So
now are your just got a question here. So are your internships still going to be, are you still planning to run those moving forward, even with
One of the best things that we do is you have to be an employee first. So, you know, someone's not just going to come to us and say, oh, will you help me with this internship? They actually have to be employed. So if you're a part-time employee that's already in the class and in, you know, whatever department you're working with, we would then be able to do that. It kind of goes along the line of like trusting you and understanding you as an employee. So that is the most important part of it, is actually becoming an employee first. Sure. If that's the case and you're an employee, yeah, the internship is really something that has no issue at all. And we'll continue doing that.
All right. Well, we got one question here from Heather. And she said, Tanya, you said that you like to begin students at part-time. What advice do you have to someone who has been out of school and the workforce for years and would like to re-enter or start their career?
Oh, I definitely, you know, we have a range of people that work and a range of ages, and everybody who is interested, obviously we say go ahead. There's a few things on the job description you can read over as far as making sure, I think we should, you know, you have to stand for most of your shift, that kind of thing. And, but the opportunities are there. And I, as I look at that as a great starting point. Fastenal is a great company to work for. If you can start in a part-time role, we typically have part-time roles open. Those part-time roles can turn into full-time, you know, as things arise. And I've seen it happen time and time again, where people start as part-time and they really, you know, envision themselves working more hours. And then, you know, within 6 months, they're at a full-time job opens up. So what the nice part of having this many locations in our area is that it may not be at the location you were hired at, but you have access to what our internal job postings are and you can transfer. And that's a really great feature to be able, and we're very lucky that there are so many locations that that is possible. You might start out in, you know, I don't know, Little Chute and decide, you know, you'd rather be closer to Oshkosh because you live in Fond du Lac or something like that. There's so many opportunities that I would highly recommend it. You know, the point is you do most of the time you need to start as a part-time employee.
Okay. Yeah. And I mean, a lot of the information you gave was, you know, was great. I think restarting your career is sometimes, you know, you have to really focus on, you know, making sure that you can, you know, adequately highlight your skills and experiences on those resumes. Just making sure that you hit some of the keywords and really just trying to think about any of the transferable skills that you have. And like you said, sometimes starting on a part-time basis may be the key to getting your foot in the door that opens up to those larger opportunities. So we have about 2 minutes left here. If any other questions from the group, and again, just anyone that is watching the video on our website or on YouTube, please make sure to email your questions to employmentconnections@fbtc.edu, and those questions will be, you know, answered either in an email format or also you can make sure to anybody in this can schedule an interview or schedule a mock interview, a resume review with me or one of our other employment advisors, and we can help you you know, get through those applicant tracking systems and hopefully get more response to your resume. So we don't have any other questions, so I will wrap it up here and thank you for taking the time, Tanya, to come and speak with us today. A lot of great information, and we hope that you know, the people in attendance can join us for our next sessions here. I will put on the screen our next session that we are going to be having. Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Manager of Employment Connections. Thank you, Ty.
Thanks, Glenn. Bye-bye.